Let's talk about some things that are useful. I'm going to start out with one of the early versions of Google's Android operating system. This is running on a T-Mobile device, and this is the New York City Wayfinder. And what this enables you to do is, I'm in New York City, I know where I am, but I don't quite know which direction I'm facing, and I don't know exactly what the destination is that I'm looking for. And as you can see in real time, this user is able to actually see which subways are in their vicinity. And in fact, I don't know if I'm standing in the southeast corner. For those of you that don't spend a bunch of time in Manhattan, finding out which corner you're on in Manhattan actually is really, really important. And I've actually used this a number of times when I've been in New York, trying to find the right subway, trying to find the right line. Why is it successful? Because people are already ready and willing mobile mapping. If you walk down the streets of San Francisco, for all of you that aren't local, I'm sure a lot of you have pulled out your BlackBerry, pulled out your iPhone to check, where am I, which way am I going? We're layering a technology onto an experience that consumers are already having. It's supporting a context, which is a very important question. A lot of times when I'm walking up and down the streets and I see someone looking at their GPS unit, they still don't know quite which way they're facing and which way to go. And so being able to show them, hey, you're facing this way, this is where you're headed, it is a problem that consumers are having. It is solving that problem. Another example of useful augmented reality is the USPS has the ability to answer the question, will this fit in my box? They superimpose a translucent box over a set of packaging, and you'll see it's actually sizing it appropriately based on having an 8.5 by 11 piece of paper sitting on a table. And for those of you that ship a lot of things, have an office manager, the problem of finding, does this work and will this fit in a box, 99% of the time, doesn't matter. But that 1% of the time that I really don't feel like walking through the rain to the post office to figure out that this won't fit in a box, it solves a problem that's very meaningful, very poignant, and can lead to loyalty. The next time I'm facing that exact same problem, I'm going to solve it the exact same way. This, like I said, is my first example, actually, with augmented reality. And this is my favorite one, because this is me in the video. This is in London. And I, since I was a very small boy, have absolutely loved Lego. And what this technology allows you, I hope you can see it in the video, is I'm holding a box of Legos. If you can go back for me, please, and pause the video on that. I'm holding a box of Legos in front of a camera. And again, since I'm exactly the same size as a 10-year-old kid, this works perfectly. And you'll see on the monitor that the computer's actually superimposing the model of the Legos that I'm looking at right onto the box. And not